Hello guys, this is Miss Red Fox. Welcome to my channel. As you know, it's the end of the week, which means it's pop culture rundown. So I'm going to give you the tea on Beyonce, Cardi B, the Kardashians, a little bit of Kanye, and a little bit of Eminem. So let's get the ball rolling with Miss Queen B. So let me give you guys a moment here to think and marinate. I'm going to ask you a question. Do you think that Beyonce and Jay-Z would ever lie about their ticket sales? You done thinking? Well, don't worry. You didn't have to waste any brain cells. I did an investigation for you. And let me just start off by making this very clear. I'm not a crazy fan of Beyonce, but I am a fan of Beyonce. I love her performance. I think she's incredibly talented, and I think that she showed the world with her Coachella performances. Nobody could get away from footage and hearing about her performance. It was so well. So I will give you guys two examples here from my investigation. And numbers don't lie, so don't come at me. This is just what it is. Just laying the facts out for you guys. The first one is the US Bank Stadium. As normal, Beyonce and Jay-Z claimed it was a sold-out venue. We sold 33,000 tickets upon my research, and the thing is, guys, it seats 66,000 people. That is literally 50% only. That's not sold out. And I highly, highly doubt that this stage takes up half of the stadium. And then you've got the US Bank Stadium. There they said they sold out. But they sold 44,000 tickets. Which is funny because that venue was actually smaller than the first one. And remember, the first one, they only sold 33,000. The thing is, on the second one, even though it's smaller, it's only by 1,000. It's 65,000 seats. And they sold 44,000 tickets. But guys, I don't know. Numbers don't lie. I'm sorry. Sorry, not sorry, but you know what it is. If I could give advice to Beyonce, I would say, girl, this is your second run on the run tour too, right? The first time you came out on the run tour with Jay-Z, people wanted to see it because you guys were a powerful couple, but now they got their fix. But of course you're going to have those diehard fans that's going to see you 10 times over. But you're not going to sell out those huge venues. So if you still want to do these tours with your husband, go for the smaller venues. Because people just want to see you, Beyonce. You could probably sell those big stadiums out if it's just you. Or you with Destiny's Child. Because people love you or just Destiny's Child. People are not feeling Jay anymore. In fact, you can pull a Kanye West and do a 7-song album with Destiny's Child and go touring with that. Fans will love you for that. People that's not your fans, but fans of Destiny's Child would like that. That's just my two cents. If I was to do any advising. Anyways, let's talk about Cardi B. I am a big fan of Cardi B, but she's been getting in a few altercations, and I'll start off with the first one. There's two bartenders working at the strip club. She got into a fight with them because of Offset's cheating ways. The thing is, it was only 50% true. The employees that worked there said that they can only confirm, and they only know for sure that he had cheating ways with one, not two, of the bartenders at the strip club. With Jane and not Baddy G. So the girls are pressing charges against Cardi B for harm. But the thing is, when the fight happened and they got home, they posted all over Snapchat that they didn't get touched and they weren't hurt, laughing it off, trying to be hard, basically. And Cardi B, from the get-go, said, nobody touched nobody. And the eyewitnesses and the employees' stories resemble Cardi B's story. They said words were said, drinks were thrown. In fact, even though drinks were thrown, the liquid didn't land on anybody. So basically, they walked away scratch-free, bruise-free, and dry. So it seems to me that Cardi B doesn't have to worry about anything. These girls are not going to get money. They opt for their 15 minutes and they're trying to get some money, but it's not going to work out. In fact, I think Cardi B should be suing them for defamation of character, because if they're claiming that she is violent, it could hurt her brand. So I would sue them. So, the second fight. Nicki Minaj just recently at the New York Fashion Week. So let me give you the backstory before I tell you what happened. Nicki Minaj first discredited Cardi B's success. Then she's telling people that if they're going to work with Cardi B, they're not going to work with her. Then she goes on social media and she likes posts that is insulting Cardi B's ability to parent her child. So Cardi B tried to take the high road three times. Approached her once, approached her twice, approached her three times, thinking each time it was resolved. But it never was. Nicki still ran her mouth. So Cardi B reached her breaking point. So, even in her nice gown and heels and beat face, when she saw that woman at New York Fashion Week, she took off those shoes. She ripped her dress. Her ass was hanging out. But she didn't care. She wanted to lay a punch on Nicki for all the things that she's been doing to her. The thing is, Cardi B couldn't get to Nicki because Nicki was surrounded with a lot of security. So nothing really happened there. Cardi B did end up walking out with a huge golf-size bump on her forehead because one of the bodyguards said he mistakenly hit her on the head with his elbow when he was trying to stop her. Because you watch the footage, she was persistent. She kept on trying to get to Nicki. You could hear Nicki yelling things, but there was so much noise and commotion in the video, you could not hear what Nicki was saying to Cardi, but you can hear what Cardi was saying because whoever was filming it was closer to Cardi. So that is the tea on Cardi B's situation. We'll see what happens after this. The only thing I can think of is in the future, when there's events that call for both of them to be there, I think the venue is going to end up choosing, you know, one or the other and disinviting the other one because they're not going to want this type of drama at the event. So that's going to be interesting to see how this plays out. So let's now talk about the Kardashians. I'm going to leave at the bottom here a link to an article. And the article is basically saying, is the Kardashian brand done? It seems the the numbers that the value of their name is diminishing. And I'll give you a summary. If you're interested in the numbers and further details, it's quite an extensive article. So if you're interested in the story and want to know more, just click on the link. So here's my rundown. Magazine covers. Doesn't matter which Kardashian sister, which Jenner sister is on the cover. It sells lower than normal than when anybody else is on the cover. You can put anybody else on the cover and the magazine will sell in more numbers than when the Kardashians or Jenners are on the magazine covers. So people are not only not getting the magazine, or it actually seems to me that they are discouraged to get it and see them on it. So that's one case. The second one is that the show on Channel E, Keeping Up the Kardashians, is experiencing lower ratings. That is why Kourtney and Kim put on a fake feud and was basically saying with their whole marketing, if you want to see what we're fighting about, tune in to the season premiere. And that was all BS. It was because they were scared of the numbers being in really low, and I don't want that to get out. Even if it got out, Kris Jenner would probably pay off the tabloids not to think that. That's what they do. So, I just want to say this to people who don't like the Kardashians. I don't like them either. Not even by 1%. I think they're probably one of the worst role models to ever exist for my generation and younger. I'm going to give you guys three tips. If you really want to see them disappear and not oversaturate the market, follow these three tips. Number one, yes, we cannot pick up the phone and cuss Kim out, Chloe out, whoever out, and we pissed at them for the way that they behave and the things that they do. The thing is, we go to social media. And that's our only outlet to voice our opinion and let them know it. The thing is, comments is conversion rates. So, whether it's negative or positive, you're contributing to the numbers, which makes the brand more valuable to other brands to work with them. And then they get things like the Calvin Klein ad, which shouldn't have happened. So don't comment. Don't follow. None of that. Don't contribute to the conversion rate, okay? Number two. Even though we like to watch people we don't like because we want to scream and shout at the screen because it's an outlet, because we can't yell at our boss, we can't look to our loved ones, because we don't want to lose our job and we don't want to hurt our loved ones. Just find somebody else to hate and scream and watch their show. Don't watch theirs, you're just helping them and they're laughing all the way to the bank because their haters are probably the people that's making them wealthy. So, and as I said, most of the stuff is fake on this show. As somebody I worked with worked for them, and 95% of the stuff is fake, and the stuff that is real they embellish on. So just not worth it, guys. Don't watch it. The third part is when you're on social media, when you're on the internet, when any link says Kardashian this or has their picture on it, even if it's just about funny memes making fun of the Kardashians, and they have, you know, like they do in Snapchat, don't click on it, because you're telling the media who those links belong to that the Kardashians equals high click-through rates, which is more advertising revenue for them, they want a lot of traffic on their site. And if they're getting you to their site using the Kardashians, they're going to post more stuff about the Kardashians. So let's not do that. Avoid all temptation, and then you'll get what you want. Next, Kanye West, of course, is related to Kim K. A perfect transition here. As you know, or if you don't, I'll tell you, Kanye West was on a late night talk show, and he made it quite clear that he likes Pornhub and watches Pornhub, and his favorite type of Pornhub to watch. So, what did they do? Pornhub sent him a free subscription for life. But apparently, they went a step further. They made Kanye West creative director of Pornhub. I think they got the wrong person. I think that they should have asked Kim K to be creative director of Pornhub. Why? You ask? Well, I'll tell you why. Because that woman made her career off porn. She's not a reality star. No. Her sisters are reality stars. Kim is the most famous porn star to be walking this planet in history. So since she made and built her career off it, I find that she is perfect to be the creative director for Pornhub. And Kanye, you wanted to be a creative director for a luxury fashion brand. And now look at you, you are the creative director of Pornhub. You know what? That is probably why you're also on a apology tour all over the place. It's probably related to the fact that the brand is dropping. Because it's very out of character for Kanye, and it's something that sounds like Kim would make him do. We forgot. Anyway, let's talk about someone talented, Mr. Eminem, Slim Shady. As you know, he put out the amazing album, Kamikaze, and he made this track. And in one of his tracks, he referenced Machine Gun Kelly. Machine Gun Kelly did release a response diss track. It wasn't that great, it wasn't as good as Eminem's, but it was decent. The thing is, he made a huge mistake. He talked about Eminem's daughter. And everybody knows you don't talk about Eminem's daughter. The last person to do that was Ja Rule. Have you seen Ja Rule lately? Ja Rule, is that you? Nope. Nobody. So, it's going to be very interesting to see the response that Eminem's gonna have in his diss track to Machine Gun Kelly. I just want to be one of the first people to say rest in peace, Machine Gun Kelly. It was nice knowing you. Anyway, that's it. As you know, the next video I'm going to release is gonna be a review or a tip. And please like and subscribe to my channel. And please comment below if you want me to do some research on a specific story that you want to hear about, or if you want any reviews and tips on anything that I expertise in, which is fashion, beauty, fitness, and health. And I will be trying to accommodate everybody. And please do donate to my channel, my PayPal donation. Everything goes towards this channel, so I can have better equipment to give you guys a better production. And last thing, if you see at the bottom is going to be an Amazon link. The beginning of this week, I did do a review on a foundation, Stila Glow Aqua Foundation, and I said to you guys it was really good for mature and dry skin. So if you click on there, I did the job for you, finding the best price I could so you guys can afford, so you guys can get it at a really good price. And if you click on it, you'll be surprised to see there's six other foundations. And the reason there's six other foundations is because those foundations are on my list to review, because I want to cover every skin type for everybody. So that was for dry and mature skin. Now I'm going to cover ones for dry skin, combo skin, you know, light coverage, medium coverage, full coverage, the whole shebang. So those are going to come up, but all the best prices I could find for you guys is down there in the link. So you can check out the seven foundations I am currently obsessed with and reviewing. So thank you guys so much. And again, we're all just beautiful.